Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Paulina and today I have a script. So yeah, you know what I'm going to talk about. I really want to talk with you like I can talk in Russian. So that is why I have script. If sometimes I will sound a little bit like not as usual, that's all because I have script, so okay. Today I'm going to talk with you about Russian politics. I want to discuss with you two of the most significant situations that happened not so long ago. Let's start. Under my last video, someone left a comment about constitutional amendments in my country. So let's start with this theme. In the 1st of July, in my country, in Russia, we had a voting about constitutional amendments. I want to admit that some of amendments were pretty good and wholesome. So what's the problem with these amendments? Problem number one. The main task of constitutional amendments was nullification of terms of president office. Yeah. It's not a secret that many Russians are unhappy with president's rule. So the logic of our government with these constitutional amendments, if the rules of the game disturb you, then change the game rules. Sounds inspiring, but not regarding government. Do you know what happened in Belarus? The president of this country hasn't changed for 26 years. In the recent elections, he lost. However, he still remained president. Many Russians say that Belarus nowadays is Russia in 2024. The second problem, the way of voting. So the one who went to vote had to choose between for and against 206 amendments. Some of them I can like, some of them no, but I have to choose only between for and against, not to each of amendment, the way of voting that they should to do. This for or against is to amendments in general. 206 amendments. Problem number three. Manipulation. When the media talked about the amendments, everyone wrote and spoke for the amendments. For example, don't forget that on the 1st of July there will be a vote for amendments to Constitution. But it's correct according to amendments. Does it make sense on English? But formulation for the amendments means that if you're against these amendments, then don't vote. Don't you think so? Advertising was bought from different bloggers. Yeah, advertising of new constitution. I'm sorry, isn't constitution is the basic law? Well, why do you advertise it like a freaking lipstick that absolutely won't influence the life of citizens and next generations? One of the amendment is connects with LGBT community. According to this amendment, you can call family only a union of men and women. So as a result, unconventional couples in Russia won't have opportunity to adopt a child. I think I will just show you the advertise of this amendment. Just watch.
Ой, я так рада. У нас сегодня мальчишку усыновили. Петенька, ты рад, что у тебя появятся мама и папа? А вот и папа.
Ну, привет.
Привет.
Пойдем?
Где моя мама?
Так вот она, твоя новая мама. Ну что ты, не расстраивайся. Теперь у тебя будет настоящая, полноценная семья. Спасибо вам большое. Мы поедем.
Какую Россию ты выберешь? Реши будущее страны. Голосуй за поправки в Конституцию.
Absurd. Nothing else. So by doing this stuff, the government managed people. One of the main tasks of our government nowadays is to create a generation that doesn't know how to think and reflect. The generation of biological mass, not people, that only can work like a robot. That's what I wanted to say about constitutional amendments. Now let's talk about what is happening in my region. In the 90th of July in 2020, the governor of Khabarovsk region was arrested. First of all, let's talk about how it went. Riot police stopped the car where he was, ran his hands, handcuffed it, pressed his face to the car. It looked like he's a serial killer or etc. But he didn't even show any resistance. His arrest looked like showing off. No more. Then, why he was arrested? Because he killed someone in criminal 19th. You know what? Our governor isn't a surprise for our government, because he's a political figure about 15 years. And did they really arrested him because they realized that he's a killer? I don't think so. Personally, I don't believe to this killness, but I can't deny that he could do it. But the main problem here is that he was arrested because for some reasons he interfered the government, not because he's a killer. So if someone interfered you, it's simpler to just put in jail this person, right? No problem. This is how our government and justice work. People have been attending a rally for 20 days or more. On the first day, about 50,000 people came to the rally. For reference, the population of Khabarovsk is 600,000. But not the media, not even a local TV channel, didn't say a word about this. Only a couple of weeks later, in the news they said 2,000 people went to the rally in Khabarovsk city. Seemingly one country, but for some reasons Khabarovsk territory and in general most of the country simply doesn't exist. I can't say that our governor was the best, but he did a good job. For example, cut the salary for him and his colleague. We don't have opportunity to come back our governor anymore. But people won't give up, because we can't be silent anymore and watch how cool the Moscow is developing at our expense. Look how beautiful I wrote the end. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any thoughts about it, comment down below. If you have any questions, comment down below. And I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.